How's it going, guys? This is Decor3 from fightinggamesonline.info, and today I want to introduce you to Anki, a program that can help you with improving your execution. While execution has many variables when it comes to fighting games, there's one constant among all of them that is of most importance: muscle memory. Combos are situational and require you to recall them instantly after landing a hit confirm. While some may be easy to commit to memory and perform, others can be quite an ordeal to remember. There's one method in particular that was researched by a German psychologist in the late 1800s that'll help you commit all of your combos to memory at a faster rate than you may have been able to do on your own. Hermann Ebbinghaus discovered what we know today as the forgetting curve, the rate at which we forget information. In addition to the forgetting curve, Ebbinghaus also identified methods that would help bring those things that were in our short-term memory into our long-term memory. This discovery would later lead to programs known as spaced repetition software, or SRS for short. Anki is one such program, and for this tutorial, I will be taking you through Anki and showing you how to set up your combos so that you can practice them for your characters of choice. If you would like to follow along, I have put a link in the description box below. Now let's get started. The Anki software is pretty simple. For this tutorial, we will create a new deck for another character that I'm pretty familiar with. You will find the Create Deck option here. Clicking on it will bring up a new window where you can enter the name for your desired character. Once you have typed in the name, click OK. This will bring us back to the main window where you will see the new deck. Clicking the name of the new deck will take us to another area, but let's go back for just a second by clicking the deck section. As you might have already noticed, our new deck is now covered in gray, which means anytime we hit the add button above, it will go directly to that deck. Remember that anytime you want to add information to your deck, you have to click on the name of that associated deck. Now we just have to click the add button. Before we enter the first combo, let's take a look at some basic options to make sure everything works correctly. Click on the fields button. If you have ever used flashcards before, then you should be familiar with how this will work. While we suggest you have a front and back card, there are options that will allow you to customize things any way you would like to by adding additional fields or taking fields away. Clicking the cards button will give you a template of how things will look once you start using the deck. Once again, you can customize things the way you would like them to be. Now we are ready to enter our combos. On the front field, I enter the type of combo I will be doing. On the back field, I enter the notations needed in order to do the combo. Just like flashcards, the front field has the question and the back field has the answer. Because you can share your deck with other people, there are additional options for your fields that you may want to consider, like adding audio, pictures, or video. Once you are happy with what you have entered, hit the add button. For this example, I'm going to add one more. When you are done with adding cards to the deck, click the close button. This will take you back to the main screen where you can see the two decks that were added. Now that we have some combos added, it is time to see how well we can perform them. Clicking the deck's name will once again take you to the area where you will begin your study. Once you click the study now button, you want to head to the training room and practice your combo. While the main goal is how well I perform the combo, the cards are also designed to make sure I remember my notations as well. It will be up to you to decide how much and how many times you want to give yourself to complete your created task. Once you feel like you have accomplished the combo, go back to Anki and hit the Show Answer button. The answer will reveal what is on the back field of the card, but that is not all. Take a look at these three options. Here you can honestly grade yourself on how well you did. Did you remember your combos? Were you able to perform them easily? Well, then you will probably want to select the easy button. Were you able to remember your combo but had some difficulties executing it? Then hit good. Did you have a hard time trying to remember your combo? Or was it really difficult for you to execute? Then hit again. Notice that each option has a timestamp above it. Depending on how many cards you have in your deck and which option you choose, you may just see the combo again in a few minutes, or you may see it in a couple of days. Remember, for this to work the way it was intended, you will need to be consistent. However, you can customize the deck to suit your own schedule, so bear this in mind. If you ever decide that you need to delete or tweak some of the cards in your deck, the browse option will allow you to do so. That is all there is to it. As a word of advice, make sure when you are creating your cards to include practicing your combos on both sides as well. You don't only have to focus on combos either. You can use the deck to focus on all sorts of situations when using the training room. I hope that you find Anki to be useful on your journey to becoming a master. Good luck and take it easy.